This is the IO3 minus Lewis structure, the iodate ion. For IO3 minus, we have a total of 26 valence electrons. Iodine is the least electronegative. We'll put that at the center, and then we'll put the oxygens around the outside. We have 26 valence electrons for IO3 minus. We'll put two between atoms to form chemical bonds. We've used 6. Then we'll go around and fill the octets for the oxygen. So we have 6, 8, 10, 24, and then back to the central iodine, 26. So it looks like we're done. Each of the atoms has 8 valence electrons, so the octets are satisfied, and we've used 26 valence electrons. However, when we look at this structure, iodine is below period 2, row 2, on the periodic table. That means iodine can have an expanded octet, can have more than 8 valence electrons. So we really need to look at the formal charges here to see if this is the most likely structure for IO3 minus. For the iodine, iodine has 7 valence electrons on the periodic table. Non-bonding, we have 2 right here who are not involved in a chemical bond. Minus bonding, we have 2, 4, 6, which we'll divide by 2. That gives us a plus 2 formal charge for the iodine. For the oxygens, and they're all the same, so we'll just do 1. Oxygen is 6 valence electrons from the periodic table, minus non-bonding, we have 6 non-bonding, minus bonding, 2, divided by 2, that gives us a minus 1 formal charge for each of the oxygens. We really want our formal charges to be as close to 0 as possible. We'll still need to retain the negative 1, of course. To do that, we can form a double bond with the oxygen by moving these valence electrons and share them with the iodine. That'll result in a formal charge of 0 on this oxygen and a plus 1 on the iodine. So we're getting close. Let's form another double bond between this oxygen and the iodine. When we do that, this oxygen has a formal charge of 0, and now the iodine has a formal charge of 0. We're still using 26 valence electrons, and each of the atoms, oxygen atoms, have octets. The iodine has more than 8, but that's okay because it can have an expanded octet. Our formal charge for this entire structure here shows up to be negative 1, which makes sense. This is a negative ion. Because the formal charges are close to 0 with this structure, that makes this the more likely Lewis structure for IO3 minus. One last thing, we do need to put brackets and a negative sign around the Lewis structure to show that it's a negative ion. And that's the Lewis structure for IO3 minus. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.